Okay. Because of that, you have so many questions for me. What is going on right now, right here? Today, many people have seen the sunspot by their own naked eyes, but they have to wear the solar glasses. The sunspot 3190 is so big. Many people had took the photo or with even the mobile phone, you still can see it. And the mobile phone can see many colors on the sun and the other. But the fact we found that, let me see. Okay, right here, John Tracker had posted someone take the sunspot from Hawaii. Look at the sunspot 3190. When we make the comparison from the image from NASA, it does look like that sunspot 3190 is rotating from top down. You can see that the big one right here and three dots around here, and compared to this photo. So sunspot 3190 supposed to be at the south hemisphere around this area and rotate from left to right. But when this guy take the photo, he have seen sunspot in this position, so it rotate top down. It about 90 degree different from NASA image. Again, when I took the sunspot from my location, the photo is almost not the same, but from bottom up and what and top down. One more thing, you have to realize about this information. When you have to make the evaluation about how high we are, right now we have a three step. The first one, we check it by GPS, by satellite. The second one, the location, maybe from the mobile phone. And the third one for the barometer or air pressure. My location, I live here for about 10 years. It's about 585 by the map. But the fact it may be about 588, something like this, like as on the GPS. And location for mobile phone is usually the same. The same review, about 585. But sometimes somehow it's about 580 or something like that. But about 10 or 20 meter different from the GPS. And the barometer, the air pressure, almost the same. Three of them maybe differ about 10 to 20 meters, but about 10 meters for a long, long time. Many years ago, the barometer changed to be really, really lower, more than the location and more than the GPS. This one used air pressure to make the measurement of how high in each location. The same that I purchased many watch that can check the altitude by receiving the air pressure around me. Therefore, right now, as I said on my post, I have found that the ionosphere at top down about 20 kilometers. What does this mean? It means the space pretty close to Earth's surface because of the weather and belt, pretty weak, and so many information, many functions. Nothing really good. Again and again, look at the energy at the sun. you can see the energy that come out from the sun, from the lunar hole, and from the sunspot. Pretty weird. Swing upside down, and this information still not generate the new one. Only on January 16. Sometimes many information are missing. Like this. Again, the sunspot. Okay. Should release about X-fair or M-fair since yesterday, but it still doesn't. The highest one about C9.3 something, not over M0 yet. Something wrong. The energy, right, had correct harmony from alpha, beta, and delta, so strong. And the area is so big, but why still keep quiet? And again, this model is not generated the whole truth, the whole fact. They still keep something behind us. Again and again, solar flare is the explosion at the sunspot. Solar flare release radiation to Earth, release radiation to all around the solar system. After solar flare, okay, it should have the solar storm by the CME corona magnetization get off those spots. But because of the angle of its sunspot, it's not really direct or facing the Earth. That's why after solar flare, the solar storm it does not hit the Earth. But right now, so many sunspots that facing to Earth, therefore the solar storm after solar flare are hitting Earth since 14. You can hear the news about the explosion, about the fire, so many places. And the frog all around the world. But when I really look at that frog, I think it means you may say that not really frog, but I don't know how to say in English, but it's not good. It looks like the moisture plus the charged particle or something, very very nano. Even in my house at night, when I wake up, when I walk out to my kitchen, look like something with pretty white about it, not yet a frog, but I don't know what they are, but it's not normal. We still lack of knowledge, so many things. One thing for sure that when the unveil are pretty weak and close to the Earth's surface. And one thing that we're so sure that about the north and south magnetic pole, pretty weak, and so many times it doesn't generate the power at all. More earthquake, more volcanic eruption. I say volcanic because it's not only the volcano, okay? In the technical term would volcanic activity, because maybe on the surface as a ground soil or the surface of the seabed, the earth plate could be cracked, let the carbon dioxide go out, let the magma come up, and we call lava later when it out of the earth surface. Look at the north and south magnetic right now. You can see that sometimes somehow it's quite very very thinly. One beginning and every 8 minutes. example, at this instant time, there are no magnetic field come out from the north and the south. And come back again. Look at that shape. Now they're gone again. When they come back, look at the knot. It looks like you squeeze something. From the big one to be small like this. And at the south, you can see that by yourself. That's why we got the weird weather. Many storms from the Pacific go to the west coast of the Northern America. You have to search by yourself through Google about the pole shift. Okay, sometimes somehow I couldn't answer all of the question because some people just start to realize what is going on and what will be happen. It takes time to explain what is going on. I take about 9 years to complete my book, about 660 pages, about the pole shift, about this apocalypse. And I could not explain it to you in a short article or maybe only short speed. Let's see by your own eye. Right now, the human resonance, or we call the earth heartbeat, you can see that it about 6 something to 2. Usually it must be 7.8. And again, during this time, there are so many solar storm pour through earth. Therefore, the cosmic ray get less to the earth surface. Many earthquake are across to the sulfur dioxide on earth. Indian Ocean, that the Bengal, right, South India and West India, how could have the sulfur dioxide at the ocean? How could we get the sulfur dioxide at the northeast of Siam, Cambodia, Laos, and some part of Vietnam? Don't say that it comes from the wind from China. No, no, no. And again, look at this area. There are the Himalaya mountain or the earth roof. How could they have so many sulfur dioxide in those areas? Even right here, in China, very few factory in this area, very few people live to this area. It's dry country and not in good weather condition. How do you get the sulfur come out from the Yellow Sea, from the Japanese Sea? Of course, sulfur dioxide may be mixing with the wind and cloud, but where they come from, right? Another thing, in the past, let's say about 15 days, west coast of the North American continental had been hit about 9 storms. Nine cyclone bomb. How do they have the cyclone storm or the whatever you say that on January? 9 of them had been hit California, Los Angeles. Look at this map. Another 1, 2, 3, 4 is coming. It's not completely yet. More storm, lower pressure will flow from the west to the east. Nothing normal. Actual time like this. Right now, the west coast of Alaska, Canada, and Washington, Oregon, are hit by this storm, we query many moistures, rain and water. Please check by yourself to the Google. I'm so tired, sorry, I can speak pretty well today. This clip, someone tell me that a fireball falling from the sky hit in the New York, the center of New York. They have information, New York or the city of New York. Okay, I don't have enough energy to say anything else. Keep in mind, okay, pole shift, it happened before so many times. The next event, it should be at any time from now to maybe 2027. Let's say right now, January 2023rd. So the latest one about next 4 years. But I don't believe it will happen in the next 4 years or during the next 4 years. After this June or on the June, maybe June 21st, the big event will happen. Before that big event, in this month January, I believe that we will lost so many lives on Earth, and the huge one should be on March 23rd. Just listen to me and just prepare yourself. It may not happen, but I believe it will happen, especially the huge earthquake that creates tsunami and another plate movement that creates tidal wave. The difference between tidal wave and tsunami is on tsunami happened after the big earthquake about 8.3. The water will reduce and coming back again. So many people who live there by the seaside, the seashore, can observe those phenomena. But the tidal wave is not the same. The huge wave, pretty high, with a lot of momentum, come from the sea without the water receding at the seashore. So nobody knows. They will realize that when that wave pretty close to the seashore, about 50 meter or 100 meter, no time to escape. We are facing those events. Take good care of yourself. Help yourself before your God help you.